Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, and today is a new chapter. The name of chapter is Laplace Transform. Basically, we are going to use this Laplace Transform in many of the applications. First of all, we'll study what is a Laplace Transform. A Laplace Transform is a technique which is used to convert any type of time signal into a frequency domain, a complex frequency domain. Basically, complex frequency domain is also referred as a Laplace domain or a S domain. Well, this concept is first invented by a Pierre Simon Laplace in the 1780s, and now which is useful in each and every applications or related to time signals. So first of all, we'll study the definition of Laplace transform, what it says, and then we'll move on to next related topics related to Laplace transform. So let's see. So we'll discuss now the introduction or the definition of Laplace transform. Any continuous time signal or any time signal multiplied with the exponential having a power s into t, and if it is integrated from the range minus infinity to infinity, then you are going to calculate or you are going to convert any type of time signal into a Laplace domain. So let's read the definition of Laplace transform. Now, in definition, what is it? In order to transform any type of a time signal into a S domain, first of all, we'll multiply it with the e to the power st, as I told you here. And then we are going to integrate this function or the product from minus infinity to infinity, that is the lowest or leftmost range of time to the rightmost range or value of time. And then whatever outcome you have, that outcome is called as a Laplace transformed of x of t, and it is represented by x of s, where the Laplace is represented by a capital L letter. Now we'll study how to write the equation of Laplace transform. Basically, a Laplace transform definition is classified or is divided into two parts. We can integrate the given function or a product of x of t and exponential function e to the power st in two ways. You can take the integration limit from minus infinity, that is leftmost value, to the rightmost value, that is which is infinity, or else you can integrate this function from 0 to infinity, like only a right-handed signal you can calculate. That's why the Laplace transform definition is divided into two parts. The first definition is a bilateral or two-sided Laplace transform. Let's see what is the definition or how we are going to represent the definition. A Laplace transform x of t is, we can represent it by a Laplace transform x of t. And now this Laplace transform, when a represented in Laplace domain or converted into Laplace domain, then the Laplace transform x of t is represented by x of s, and the according to definition will multiply x of t with the exponential function e to the power minus st with respect to time dt, and this time varied from minus infinity to infinity. Here the time is varied from minus infinity to infinity, that's why this equation or this definition is referred as two-sided or bilateral Laplace transform. Similarly, we can also calculate a unilateral Laplace transform. How? Just simply replace this integration limit from 0 to infinity. For that, you need to consider the given function is causal or having a time period which is greater than equals to 0. So let's see how that Laplace definition changes to unilateral Laplace transform. Now, the second definition of Laplace transform is, if the function is causal. Causal means if the function is right hand sided, or else if the function time period varies from 0 to infinity, or you can say t is greater than equals to 0, then the given function is referred as a unilateral function. Now, how to apply Laplace transform it? Let's see. If the function is a causal function, or if it is time value is greater than equals to 0, then that given function can be expressed or can be solved using Laplace transform also. So according to definition, a Laplace transform of x of t is represented like this. Now, when that function is expressed or converted into Laplace domain, then we always use to write that equation by x of s. Now, the according to formula, we'll integrate this function from 0 to infinity, because the function is causal, or else the function having time period which is greater than equals to 0. That's why this integration limit starts from 0 to infinity. Now, the product is same, the x of t into e to the power minus st dt. Here, we are going to integrate the whole function with respect to time, because your time value starts from 0 to infinity. This is the definition of unilateral or one-sided Laplace transform. Now, in this whole part, what do you mean by s first? Because your x of t is known, which is an input signal, exponential and the time t is known. But what do you mean by s? Basically, this s is the function, or you can say the complex frequency. This complex frequency is a combination of real part and imaginary part. So how that real part and imaginary part affects the time system? Let's see. Now, the complex frequency is represented by s in the exponential part. Basically, this s is the combination of real part, which is sigma, and the imaginary part, which is omega. This omega is represented by ohm value, where this sigma is Napier frequency, which is calculated in Napier per second, and this is omega. This omega is a real frequency or radian frequency and calculated in radian per second. Basically, we can replace or we can represent this whole e to the power st function by k into e to the power st. Reason is, this k into e to the power function st is considered as a universal signal with respect to time, or you can say a universal time signal. Now, if this s is substituted by sigma plus j omega, then you can substitute the sigma value a different, you can take a 0 or you can take infinity. Similarly, you can substitute the value of omega like a 0 or infinity. If we substitute 0 or any values of sigma and omega, then the operation of this whole k into st will be changed. That's why the k into e to the power st is known as a universal signal. Now, how this sigma and omega affects the operation of k into st, or how you can say that this k into st is an universal signal? Let's prove it. Now, we are going to substitute the values of sigma and omegas. We are going to substitute different values. So, I have classified all this operation in different cases. I have classified or I have made it or I have chosen four different cases for sigmas and omega. Let's first of all substitute s value. Here x of t is a into e to the power st, where a is the amplitude. It can be any integer value, and s is substituted like sigma plus j omega. Now I'm going to substitute the values of sigma and omega. How? In the first part, I've substituted sigma value 0 and omega value by omega naught. Here, the sigma value is 0 and omega value is omega naught. If I substitute sigma value 0, then the e to the power 0 plus j omega naught. Basically, the function of x of t is this was the original function. After substituting sigma equal to 0, what you can say? You have only omega value, and omega value is omega naught. So this whole part will get cancelled. What else remaining? E to the power j omega t, only the imaginary part. Now, we know that exponential function with imaginary value, you can say that exponential function with the imaginary value means it is a combination of cos and sine, or you can say a complex function, trigonometric function. E to the power x of t or e to the power I omega is represented by cos of omega t plus I j sine omega t. You can say a j also, or you can say I also. So after substituting or after multiplying this omega exponential value in this function, the whole equation is represented by a cos of omega 0 t plus j sin omega 0 t. So, just substituting after cos omega 0 t and sin omega 0 t, we can say that it is a combination of a real part having a cosinusoidal function and imaginary part as a sinusoidal function. So, this equation or this x of t after substituting sigma equal to 0 and omega equals omega naught, having two different values, a real part with amplitude a, having a cos function or cos signal with the frequencies omega naught, and the imaginary part of x of t having amplitude a a sinusoidal function or sinusoidal signal with frequencies omega naught into t. Now, this is all about sigma equal to 0 and omega equal to omega naught. This was the first case. Now, we are going to substitute different types of sigma and different values of sigma and omega. So, that will be our case number 2. Let's see how that omega and sigma reacts or changes the value of x of t. Let's see. Now, in second case, we are going to substitute your real or radian frequency by 0. If I substitute radian frequency as a 0, then basically the equation, the x of t equation is, I'm going to write it. This was your original equation. If in this case, if the real frequency or radian frequency omega is 0, then you can say that this whole part becomes 0. If this imaginary part becomes 0, which means we have only a real part on power side, or you can say that the exponential having only a real power, imaginary value becomes 0. So what you have, x of t is a into sigma into t. Now, from this equation, you can say that this sigma can have two different values. This sigma may be having a positive value or may be having a negative value. If sigma is positive or is sigma negative, then exponential signal may increase or may decrease, or you can say the amplitude of exponential signal will increase or will get decrease. So let's see how this sigma affects. If the sigma value is positive, then the signal will exponentially increasing, means at t equals to infinity, the amplitude of equation or exponential is also infinite. If I substitute sigma is negative or sigma is having minus value, then the graph will start to decrease or decaying exponential, you can say. Now, for t equals to infinity, the graph may have or exponential may produce a zero value. That's why it is mentioned for positive signal, or if the sigma is positive, the signal will exponentially increases, and if a sigma is negative, then signal will exponentially decreases with respect to time. This is all about a omega equal to 0. Now let's move on to third case. What or which value we are going to substitute in sigma? Now, in third case, I'm going to substitute sigma and omega value as a 0. If the real part and imaginary part of power is 0, then the whole power becomes 0, and if the whole power of exponential becomes 0, then e to the power 0 is always 1, and if e to the power 0 is 1, then what you will get? Let's see. This e to the power sigma plus j omega t was your original equation. After substituting 0 of sigma and omega as a 0, both the values or both the powers will get 0, become 0, and if e to the power we have 0, then e to the power 0 is always 1. What you will get? Amplitude a at the end. If your amplitude is a, which means you have only a step signal with amplitude a. If I consider your a is value 1, then you can say that you are having a unit step signal. But if a is not equals to 1, then system produces only a step signal with amplitude a, and this a can be having any integer value. Now we will move on to the last most important part of this equation. Now here we are going to substitute sigma, which is not equals to 0, and omega is also not equals to 0. So let's see how system will respond or signal will respond. Now the last case, the case number 4. Here the omega and sigma value is not 0. We are going to substitute some values of sigma and omega. So here the sigma value is not 0 and omega value is also not equals to 0, but omega, I'm going to substitute omega naught. If I substitute both the values in my equation, then equation is e to the power sigma plus j omega naught into t. Just we'll separate these exponential powers. We know that e to the power a plus b is e to the power a into e to the power b, which is the basic formula that we have studied in maths also. We'll use that same mathematical formula. So this is a and this is b, this whole part is b and this sigma part is a. So e to the power a plus b is nothing but e to the power a into e to the power b. So what do you get? We'll get to different values of exponential, one with the real power and one with the imaginary power of exponential. Now we have studied the effect of sigma and effect of omega separately. Now when we have e to the power imaginary values, which means we have a complex exponential, we can use a complex exponential formula. The complex exponential formula is cos theta plus I sin theta. If the order of this exponential having positive sign, then you're going to write a plus over here or in between the formula. If you have a negative sign or the complex power is negative, then we are going to substitute minus sign over here. Right now we have positive value, so e to the power j omega formula is cos omega plus j sin omega. This was the formula. Just multiply this a into e to the power sigma t inside this bracket. What you can see, this real part will be separated and imaginary part will get separated. Because in real part we have only sigma into t in exponential power, a is a real and cos term is also real because we don't have any imaginary sign, just as we have in second part. What is this equation shows? This equation shows the combination of exponential cosinusoidal signal and as a real part and imaginary with exponential with sinusoidal signal. This shows that if this is the real part and this was the imaginary part, then it depends on values of sigma, your graph may increase or may get decrease. So this x of t is a combination. We can conclude that this x of t is a combination of a real part, a real exponential part, or you can say real with exponential part having a cosinusoidal signal and imaginary with sinusoidal part. This equation shows that it is a combination of real part and imaginary part. First of all, a real part. Real part consists of exponential signal with sigma value. This exponential signal depends on sigma. If sigma is positive, then amplitude of exponential signal will increase. And if sigma is negative, then exponential signal amplitude will decrease. Now, depends on this, the cosinusoidal signal will amplitude will get increase or decrease. So you can say that this part or x of t having a real part with exponential increasing or decreasing amplitude of cosinusoidal signal. Next, similar to imaginary part also. So imaginary part will also show the same response. It is also having exponential with increasing or decreasing amplitude with the sinusoidal signal. So we can express or we can split this equation in two ways. Like a real part of x of t is nothing but a e to the power sigma cos omega 0 t, where the sigma plays most important role. If sigma is positive in both the equations, if sigma is positive, then amplitude will increase, and if sigma is negative, then amplitude will decrease. If amplitude will increase, then cos omega t amplitude will continuously goes on increasing till infinity. But if sigma is negative, then the amplitude of cosinusoidal signal will goes on decreasing with respect to time. Now second part is imaginary part. Imaginary part also consists of e to the power sigma omega t. As I told you earlier, the sigma plays an important role, which can increase or decrease the amplitude. That's why the sinusoidal response will also increase or decrease the amplitude according to sigma value. So this is all about a frequency value. S plays, S that is a complex frequency, plays an important role in a time signal, with respect to time signal or on time signal. This is all about introduction. Now we'll study more about Laplace transform in next videos. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you so much.